All right, another highly requested video. I'm extremely excited to present the health degree tier list. What is so damn fascinating about these tier lists? Seriously. It's like the most random subjects, like the Tetris tier list, will pop up on my feed and I will watch them. I think a lot of you can relate to this. It pretty much doesn't matter what subject it is. I just automatically click on it.
I'll take your entire stock.
And as always, don't forget to smash like if you feel the same way, because it's good karma. Now, most of the time, these types of videos are a total waste of time, but today is your lucky day. That's right, because today we are gonna go over the health degree tier list, and I'm gonna tell you the best and the worst health degrees. And I am someone who is a healthcare professional myself, and probably over half my friends are too, so these rankings are gonna be perfectly accurate. Just kidding, this is obviously just my opinion, so if you disagree with me, instead of getting triggered and leaving comments like this, go ahead, scroll below, let me know your opinion, and if you make a good point, then we all learn from it and we all win. All right, so let's jump right into it. First one on the list is going to be dental hygienist. Now, this one requires about 2 to 3 years of schooling, and it has a really great salary for that short amount of time. The median pay is around $75,000 a year, which is excellent. There are over 219,000 jobs right now, and it's growing at about 11% per year, which is much higher than average. Now, one of the great things about a lot of these health degrees is it's very obvious what the career that you're gonna go into is once you graduate with a degree. You know, nurse graduates end up becoming nurses, you know, nurse is gonna nurse. Dental hygiene degrees end up becoming dental hygienists. It's a very clear path to what career you're gonna go into. You don't have to wait for something to fall into your lap. And this is a very solid and stable job that you can get with only a few years of schooling. And one of my old roommates had a girlfriend that was a dental hygienist, and she was able to work part-time and take vacations whenever she wanted. It offered a really good lifestyle. Now, she did tell me that dental hygienists have a huge advantage if they're young and they're extroverted and outgoing, so take that for what it's worth. And most of my audience on this channel is male, but shout out to my female fans as well. Now, research has shown that women do tend to gravitate towards health degrees, as something like 80% of the health degree graduates are females. But if you're a guy, that means that you pretty much have an advantage if you go for a lot of these careers, because there's just not that many of us.
I am aware of the effect I have on women.
Just kidding, but overall, this is a great one. I'm gonna have to put dental hygienist in A tier. Next one on the list is going to be dentist, and this is a very popular one. I think everyone knows what dentists do. But in my opinion, it's a little bit overrated. Now, this is an 8-year doctoral level degree, and it requires you to generally go very deep into debt before you can start making money. Now, there are 155,000 jobs available, and it's growing at about 7%, which is faster than average, but that's actually pretty low compared to a lot of the other health degrees. Now, don't get me wrong, this one is still pretty good. If you want to become a dentist, that's your life purpose. Don't let this video dissuade you. But the average debt that a dentist takes out is $285,000. And that's actually higher than a medical doctor. And you might think, oh, that's not a big deal because you're making so much money, probably over $150,000 a year, and you can just pay it off in 2 years, right? Well, after taxes and other expenses, it'll usually take more like 5 to 10 years of frugal spending and aggressively paying off your loans before you'll get to a net worth of zero. And many dentists don't actually get to a net worth of zero until their late 30s, sometimes even their early 40s. And this one can be great if you open up your own practice, but overall, I'm gonna go ahead and give this one a B tier status. Next on the list is going to be diagnostic medical sonographer, and this is another one that takes around 2 years to get into. And in layman's terms, you're gonna help people see if they have a real baby or if it's just another quarantine food baby. Now, this one pays really well at about $67,000 a year, and it has a 14% growth rate. Now, not a lot of people know about this one, but it also has really good job satisfaction, just like many of the medical degrees do. Now, as a rule, medical degrees generally are pretty stable. Even in a recession such as the 2008 recession, where a lot of different careers are losing their jobs, medical careers tend to be pretty stable. Now, this one does pay less than dental hygienists, but there's also less licensing requirements, so to me, it kind of averages out. And it's really hard to compare 2-year degrees to like an 8-year doctoral level degree. It's almost like comparing apples to oranges. And I admit, I'm kind of biased towards degrees and careers that only take 2 to 4 years to get into versus ones that might take 8+ years. But overall, this one is going to go into A tier status. Next on the list is going to be dietetic diet/nutritionist. And I think this one is pretty self-explanatory. It's basically all about eating healthy, which I have not been doing during quarantine. And this one is probably gonna come as a surprise because it's gonna rank relatively low on the list. Now, not to say that this is a bad career, but when you're comparing it to other health degrees, it's not that great. And I think objectively, most of the health careers are either S tier, A tier, or some of the worst ones are B tier. But this one requires you to go to school for 4 years, and then it oftentimes requires an internship as well before you can start working. Now, for all that hard work, they get paid around $60,000 a year, and it's got a pretty good growth rate of 11%. And those are pretty good stats overall, but not when you compare them to other health careers. So overall, this one is going to go into F tier when you compare it to other health degrees, but I'd say it's one of the higher ones in F tier, if that makes any difference. Speaking of F tier, here's another one that goes there, and that is health and wellness. Now, this one is more of a degree that talks about the whole picture, so it's not just eating right, it's also working out and fitness. And I'm not saying that this one isn't important, especially here in the US, we kind of need this, but unfortunately, the stats aren't that good for this one, so for that reason, it goes in F tier. All right, so next on the list is going to be medical doctor, and I already made an entire video about this one. It's a little bit overrated, and I'm not gonna get too much into it, but basically, most of the other healthcare degrees have pretty good quality of life. There's a good work-life balance there, and most of the medical specialties, just to be pretty blunt about it, don't have that work-life balance. Medical school and residency are also extremely difficult, and just the job as a whole is something that not everyone can do, and I have the utmost respect for doctors. I think they deserve all the praise that they get, but the truth is most people just aren't made to work 60 to 80 hours a week for the rest of their life making life and death decisions all day long. So to me, this one is a little bit overrated with all the TV shows out there and everything. I think society kind of glorifies it, but if you're the type of person that has the personality to become a doctor, then you should definitely go for it. Overall, I think this one goes in B tier, but I would say it's pretty high B tier. I'd say it's higher than dentist. All right, so next on the list is going to be nurse, and this might be one of the most common professions in the world. And nurses are amazing. They're the backbone of the healthcare system, in my opinion. Now, it generally takes 4 years, sometimes a little bit less, to become a registered nurse. You make around $71,000 a year, and on top of that, there's an insane 3 million jobs available right now in the US, and it has a growth rate of 12%, which is incredible for that many jobs. So for that reason, nursing is gonna go into A tier. Next on the list is very closely related to nursing, which is nurse practitioner. This is one of my favorite professions. It's about a 6-year degree, and they make around $113,000 a year, which is a great salary. There's also 240,000 jobs out there, and it's growing at an insane 26%, which is way faster than average. Now, these stats are great, but I think the best thing about nurse practitioner is the fact that it's so flexible. You can do a lot of the same things that doctors do, such as prescribing and diagnosing, but you don't have to deal with all the baggage that doctors have to deal with. You're also not stuck in one career if you decided to switch later on. It's much easier to switch from, say, surgery to psychiatry, for instance, than if you were a medical doctor. I could go on here, but I think you guys get the point. This one is clearly an S tier degree. Next on the list is going to be occupational therapy assistant. Now, this one usually takes around 2 years or less, and you actually get a pretty nice salary of around $57,000 a year. And then on top of that, there's 51,000 jobs available out there, and it's growing at an insane 31%. Now, for a lot of other degrees out there, this one would be maybe S tier or A tier, but when we're talking about health degrees, they're so good that this one is only in B tier when you compare them to the other degrees. Next one on the list is going to be occupational therapy, and this is another good one that takes around 6 years to get into. And just like all the other healthcare degrees, it has pretty good stats, but you only get paid around $84,000 a year, and so for that reason, I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in B tier. Next on the list is going to be optometrist, and this one is a doctoral level degree, so it could take up to 8 years, but you make $111,000 a year, and it's growing at 10%, which is still faster than average. The stats on this one aren't quite as good as some of the other healthcare degrees, but it's still pretty solid overall. I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in B tier. Next on the list is going to be physician assistant, and this is a 6-year master level degree, and you make a very nice $108,000 a year. Now, on top of that, this one is growing at 31%, and there's 118,000 jobs available right now. This is actually one of the fastest growing careers in all of the United States. Now, this one is actually pretty similar to nurse practitioner, and it has very similar stats overall, but one advantage to PA is it's actually even easier easier for you to change specialties than as a nurse practitioner. And I have a friend who started out working in family medicine, then she switched to ER, then she switched to dermatology, and that's the one that she ended up liking, so she's pretty much stayed there for a while. And as a medical doctor, I don't think there's any way that you'd be able to do that. This one is very, very good. I'm gonna say S tier for sure. Next, we're gonna talk about physical therapy, and this is a doctoral level degree that pays pretty well at nearly $88,000 a year. On top of that, there are 247,000 jobs, and it's expected to grow at 22%. Now, this one doesn't quite get S tier because the pay is a little bit lower than some of the other six-year degrees, but it's still really good. I'm gonna go ahead and put it in A tier. All right, next on the list, this is the one you've all been waiting for. I am a pharmacist, I got a PharmD, so I can definitely speak on this one. First of all, this is a doctoral level degree, but a lot of people that I know, including myself, actually got the degree in 6 years instead of 8. I even know one girl who was able to do it in 4 years. Now, this one pays extremely well at about $126,000 a year, and there are 314,000 jobs available. All of that sounds really great, right? Wait a minute, is there something wrong with my glasses? Is that a 0% growth rate? They must have forgotten the one before the zero, right? Unfortunately, nope. Pharmacy is pretty unique among the health professions because it doesn't have a good growth rate. Now, this is for many reasons that I won't get into in this video. If you want me to, I'll make a video about it. But I personally didn't have any issues getting a job after pharmacy school, and not that many people from the school that I went to had that many issues. And in my opinion, that's because even if a healthcare profession is technically saturated, it's still considered to be essential. So even if we're going through a recession or just hard economic times, it's one of those that is not gonna be that affected. Overall, if pharmacy is your passion like it was for me, this is still a pretty good one to go into, but I would put this in low B tier status. Next on the list is going to be physical therapy assistant. Now, this one is about a 2-year degree or so, and basically what they do is they help physical therapists. Now, they get paid $48,000 a year, and there's a 26% growth rate, and that's good, but honestly, the pay is a little bit low. Overall, this one goes into C tier. Next on the list is going to be radiation therapists, and they basically treat cancer patients and other types of diseases by administering radiation therapy. Now, obviously, this is a pretty difficult job. I don't know if I could do it myself, but this is a 2-year degree, and it honestly has some of the best statistics on the entire list. The pay is amazing for a 2-year degree at $82,000 a year, and it has a 9% growth rate with 18,000 jobs available. The stats on this one are incredible, and I almost put it in S tier, but I think I'm a little bit biased towards it just because I don't know if I could do this one myself, so I decided to put this one in A tier. It's a tough job, and I have a ton of respect for people who can do it, and if you're one of those people, this is probably more like S tier. Next on the list is going to be a respiratory therapist, and this is a 2-year degree. It's very similar to some of the other ones mentioned, but overall the stats are just a little bit worse than some of the other 2-year degrees. So for that reason, this one is going to be in C tier. Next on the list is going to be radiologic and MRI technologists. And this is another 2-year degree that pays over $60,000 a year and it has really good stats. Again, it's not quite on the same level as some of the other 2-year degrees, but it's still a really solid option. So for that reason, it's going into C tier. Next on the list is going to be speech and language pathology. And this is a 6-year master's level degree. Now, this one actually is growing at 27%, which is one of the best on the list, and there's 153,000 jobs available right now. The downside to this one is you only get paid $77,000 a year, and it also requires an internship or a residency. So this is really good overall, but when you compare it to all the other healthcare degrees, it's a little bit less in terms of the stats. So I'm gonna go ahead and put this one in D tier. Next on the list is going to be dental assistant, and this is one that doesn't take very long to get into, but it also doesn't pay very well at all. I'm not gonna go over the stats, but they're just not that great compared to the other healthcare degrees. This one goes in F tier. And then last, it's gonna be optician, and this is another one where it's not bad overall, but the stats just don't really pan out when you compare it to the other healthcare degrees. So this one goes in D tier. All right, so that's the list. Make sure to check out my videos right here. I made them just for you. Go ahead, smash the like button, hit the subscribe button, ring the notification bell, and then comment down below any thoughts or comments that you have on the video. Thank you so much for watching, and bye for now.